When the Fisk students, Crown and keyboardist Ella Shepard, use the reed organ with her classmates to transform their memory of slave songs into arrangements of art songs for public performance, the repertoire took on a new significance. Spirituals move from improvised expression to compositional noted expression, radically shifting the ontological reception of the singer. Yet across these different contexts, singing concert spirituals remains a fraught vocal act through which essentialist relationships between blackness, singing voice, gender, and repertoire, the vocal politics of racial inequality that points towards the singing of concert spirituals as an affective labor of the feminine. Zora Neale Hurston's 1934 statement that the popular performances of spirituals as sung by the Fisk Jubilee singers, opera singers, and professional church singers are commercialized form of spirituals, which she calls neo-spirituals. The commercial recording industry successes of early black female blues singers made for a listening culture in which vocal expressions of song and the blackness of female singers overdetermined the listening ethics of the concert spirituals in the public, consequently constructing the black female as a limited voice in popular culture, and further the soprano as a voice type, which is an antithesis to the low-range, raspy, idealized vocal aesthetic of iconicized blues singing. As this trope of black soprano female lamenting took hold in 20th century concert spiritual singing reception, its affective effect gained momentum during the civil rights movement, where women accompanied male political and religious leaders in demonstrations of non-violent black singing events. The wife of Dr. Over the course of the 20th century, the commercial success of the Fisk Jubilee singers impacted composers and solo classical singers embraced the concert spirituals. Still, for many listeners, the diction of African-American vernacular English in concert spirituals is held in contradistinction to the sound of Western classical vocals. Representing the scores, which you are able to follow in the program, the diction of dialect at once challenges essentialist perception of a serious, non-violent demeanor and virtuosic vocalism of which diction is a part is an aspect of how the history of concert spiritual performance informs contemporary performance practice. As we now turn to the performances, we are listening attentively to how concert spirituals rupture divides between art and vocal music through spiritual expression on the reed organ and piano, as established by black soprano Ella Shepard, the soprano saxophone, by the great Sidney Bechet, and in the voice, in the ways that black sopranos have made space for themselves within Western classicism.
Good brave man. Samson's strength was never found out till his wife said upon his knee. She said, "Tell me where your strength lies, if you please." Now Samson's wife, she talked so fair. Samson said, "Cut off of my hair, shave my head just as clean as your hand, and my strength will come like a natural man's." Oh, Samson was a witness for my Lord. Samson was a witness for my Lord. Samson was a witness for my Lord. My soul is a witness for my Lord. There's another witness. No, there's another witness. There's another witness. My soul is a witness for my Lord. My soul.
Inducted into the Musicology Hall of Fame, the Gospel Music Hall of Fame, and the Grand Hall of Fame. Kwami's directorship of the Center for the Supreme Court in the Mountains in the United States of America, Spain, Italy, and Ghana. He was also the first to be named the Lang Group to receive the Dow Chair and the first guy to the Dow Chair. Please welcome.
Thank you. Thank you. Don't you grieve after me.
love to pray. Let God's saints come in. Our Savior taught me how to pray. Let God's saints come in. Oh, come down, angels, troubled water. Come down, angels, troubled water. Come down, angels, troubled water. Let God's saints come in. I think I heard the sinner say, let God's saints come in. My Savior taught her how to pray. Let God's saints come in. Oh, come down, angels, troubled water. Come down, angels, troubled water. Come down, angels, troubled water. Let God's saints come in.
scholar, critic, ethnographer, theorist, and artist who excels in performance, interpretation, and analysis. I think she follows in the tradition of that other great Kwami and Zorio person, except she does it on the musical side. In listening to the performances and thinking about the tradition of Black sopranos in particular, those who carry the musical spirituals onto the concert stages throughout the world, most especially throughout Europe, from Marian Anderson to Leontine Price, Harold Blackwell to Shirley Grant, Jesse Norman to Kathy and Battle, Barbara Hendricks to Denise Graves, and too many more to name. These women, master therefore, prove themselves adept interpreters of Western folk music, and then offer the gift of life to the world by including concert spirituals in their repertoire. They represent the genius and humanity of a great but underappreciated people, with elegance and excellence, and became, for many of their audience members, a first encounter with the tradition of the spiritual. In 2004, I published an essay, first presented right here in this chapter, titled When the Lily Sings, a Meditation on the Life of Lily Singers. The title, of course, was taken from Hallmark Dunbar's famous poem, Throughout, I tried to offer a historically grounded, theoretical analysis of the impact, power, and influence of Black American women singers through time and across genre. However, most of my examples in that essay were taken from gospel, jazz, and drama music. But I think what I said about those vocalists is true of classically trained singers as well, and certainly of what we heard here tonight. And I wonder now, why is it that the soprano especially is capable of creating an oral space where listeners not only hear history, not only hear the meaning and mixing of cultural and racial and ethnic traditions, but especially hear the creation of sounds which allow us to experience our full humanity, which allow us to hear ourselves as both whole and free at the same time. They create a space that is simultaneously political, spiritual, and quite often, especially in the case of the soprano, transcended. These voices have been the source of other forms of creativity and have inspired and given birth to works of theater and literature as well. They express a quality of longing for home, for love, for connection with God, for heaven, for freedom. They are a conduit between what we are and what we want to be. Consider this recollection. Last fall, a tribute from the soprano Jesse Norman, our great wordsmith Toni Morrison, recalled first hearing a recording of Miss Norman in the south of France at the home of James Baldwin. I have to stop just for a minute here. Take that.
Voice which is capable of taking the words beyond the solitary written page to through their breath, their phrasing, their virtuosity. The singers allow music to inhabit us, and we are transformed not just for our own good, but for the good of the world. Having been given this gift, it becomes our responsibility to remain in touch with our